Hey everyone, my name is Abhishek and welcome to another episode of Creative Tuesdays. So in today's video, we are going to create this text reveal animation. So before I begin, if you guys are new here, then please consider subscribing and make sure to press that bell icon so that you never miss another amazing video like this. So without wasting any further ado, let's jump into After Effects and get started. Alright, so right now I'm in After Effects. So let's begin by creating a new composition. So let's call this main. Width and height 1920x1080, frame rate 30fps, and duration you can go with whatever you want. Just click on OK. Now let's create a new solid. So you can right click, go to new solid, and let's call this BG for background. Just click on OK. And we are going to apply gradient ramp to this and just drag it onto this. Now let's select some colors. So it's completely up to you. You can pick whatever colors you want. For this one, I'm going to use these colors, so you can grab these and just place it wherever you want. It's completely up to you. So yeah, I think this is looking fine. Now let's create our text. So you can use the text tool, just simply click and you can type whatever you want. So I'm going to type think, and font you can select whatever font you want. I am using this Montserrat Extra Bold, so it's completely up to you. You can pick whatever font you want. So let me just quickly align this in the center. So if you are not able to see this align panel, then you can go to Windows and from here you can enable this. After that, let's move its anchor point in the center. So you can select the layer, then hold on Control key and then just simply double click on this pan anchor tool. And let me just quickly press S and just scale this up something like this. So now we have our text, and you can just simply right click and let's create mask from text. Just like this. Now we can probably select this layer and apply an effect called stroke. Just simply select it and drag it onto this layer. After that, just make sure that this option is checked, all stroke masks, and under the paint style, just change it to on transparent. So now you can see that we have this really nice outline of our text. We can play around with the brush thickness. So can pick whatever you want. I think this is looking good. So now let's animate this. So we are going to use the start and end property. So let's add a keyframe in the beginning and let's set both the values to 50. Now let's move to somewhere around 2 seconds and let's set the start to 100 and the end to 0. So if I play back, here you can see that we have our write on text effect. And let me just quickly select this, press U. After that, select the keyframes. You can press F9 or you can right click, go to keyframe assistant, easy is. Now let's go under the graph, and if your graph looks different, then make sure you are in the edit speed graph. Now let's select these endpoints and let's make the graph look something like this. So now if I play back, here you can see that we have this sort of animation. Let me just select these keyframes and just place it somewhere around here. So I think this is looking much better. So we are now done with our stroke animation. Now let's select this and again right click, create mask from text, and let me just quickly place it on top of this layer. We can probably select this and rename this to stroke, and let's select this and let's type scribble on this. And on this one, we are going to apply an effect called scribble. So just search for it and just drag it onto this. So right away, you can see that we have this scribble kind of effect. And under this scribble, we are going to select the all masks. So now you can see that our whole text is covered inside this scribble look. So we can probably play around with these values. So you can change the angle of the scribble. You can increase or decrease the stroke width. You can also change its color from here, and there are different options like center edge. So if you want to go with some looks like these, then you can play around with these on your own. But for this one, we are going to select the inside, and if you go under these stroke options, you can see that we have a bunch of different options over here. So you can play around with them and you can add some curviness to your text, and it's completely up to you. If you want to go with this look, then you can do that. But for this example, I'm going to leave this to default. You can also add some spacing to these lines depending on how you want. It's completely up to you. You can add some path overlays and make it look something like this. but for this example I'm going to leave this as it is. And over here you can see that we have this option called composite on transparent. Just make sure that this is selected, and after that we are going to animate it just like we did the stroke. So let's go to somewhere around here and let's add keyframe. Again, we are going to set both of these to 50. Let's move to somewhere around here and set the start to 100 and the end to 0. Now let's select this, press U, select the keyframes, press F9. Then let's change the graph and make sure that it looks something like this. So if I go back and let me just quickly play this. So here you can see that we have our really nice text animation and the scribble animation as well. You can also change the wiggles per second. You can increase them and it will make it wiggle much faster, or you can decrease them however you want. You can also add some randomness to this by simply moving this slider. So this is how you can add these kind of effect. And let me just quickly show you some variations. So you can select the stroke and let's apply drop shadow to this. So just apply it and let's set the angle to 180 degree, and I'm going to increase the softness and let's move the distance further apart. So you can see that now we have this really nice shadow. You can probably copy this and paste it on top of the scribble. So now you can see that we have this sort of look. We can probably place this scribble below our stroke, something like this. So this is how you can add some really nice variations to this. You can also change the stroke color and stroke width however you want. So this is how you can add some really nice variations to your animation. So it's completely up to you. Just play around with these settings and you can come up with different looks. And now if you want to add different text, all you have to do is just simply select this and let's type your text and let me just quickly align it and let's set its anchor point. So now all you have to do is just simply select the layer, right click, create mask from text, and let's select this and duplicate this. Now just simply copy the effects from these layers onto this. There you go. Now you can probably select this, press U, and just move the keyframes wherever you want. So now if I play back, here you can see that we already have our animations. And let's place it somewhere around here. So here you can see that now we have added the same animation to a different text. So this is how you can add these scribble kind of animation to your text layers. So I hope you learned something from this video, and if you guys have any queries or questions, then you can ask in the comments below. Also, if you want to see a particular tutorial, then you can mention your recommendations in the comments below as well. So with that being said, my name is Abhishek and I'll see you in the next one.